The first time we worked together was on The Departed, wasn't it?
That's right.
And Christopher was one of the assistants. And in fact, you did a lot of the buying, didn't you?
Yeah, I was the buyer.
You were the buyer on that, which is like a pretty huge job, considering how many clothes there were. I remember you having to sort of find doubles of everything, wasn't it? That was always the hardest thing.
That job for me was basically coming back with like eight of everything for every one of these men because they were always falling off of buildings or getting shot or getting chased. Or there were a lot of blue hoodies, as I remember.
The Irishman was what was the first job that we've sort of co-designed.
You know what Sandy's taught me is the courage of my convictions and going for it, you know, and don't be afraid of color and don't be afraid of, you know, making a mistake.
Believe this weather, Frank? Huh? It's 85 degrees outside. Perfect.
Hey, Tony Jack.
Dr. Julie. Jimmy.
People freezing to death in New York, and look at us.
Hey, Jack. Huh? Hey.
Why we don't live here all year round is what I want to know. Oh. Beautiful.
It's summer.
What?
It's summer. People aren't freezing to death in New York. It's summer.
In my mind, it's always 8 degrees in New York. I'm making a point.
Making a point? Making a point dressing like that? Is that you dress for a meeting?
And this is how you dress in Florida? In a suit?
For a meeting? Anywhere. Florida, Timbuktu, I dress in a suit. For a meeting.
I think you think a lot more about things. And I'm more...
I talk a lot more.
He certainly talks. He thinks and talks a lot more. And I'm more instinctive. I just get a feeling for something and want to do something without really analysing why. It's just I get a feeling for it. And but those two approaches then sort of and seem to work and meld together.
The work's hard. You know, the work can be quite grueling. And quite oftentimes you spend more time with your co-workers than you do with your family or your partners.
Yeah, it's like being married,
and
but
so,
for that
yeah, it's
time.
Sort of a bit of a creative marriage. It's never, oh no, we're doing this, or oh no, I want that. It's basically, how do you see it? And then if we see it differently, we just keep looking at it until we see it the same.
And yes, there are mood boards, but the mood boards for The Irishman are very specific because they're about real people. So for a lot of the time, we had images of the real people. And then maybe it was a bit more general for mood boards for crowd and the different periods. So you have a mood board for the early 50s, one for the middle of the 50s, one for the late 50s, and the same for the other decades.
You can't start unless you have some kind of a garment to at least start putting it on the actor and seeing where it's going to go. And then sometimes you find that exactly the right thing that's already there in front of you, and then sometimes that serves as an inspiration for what gets eventually, you know, made. And
or it could tell you what not to do.
Sure.
It could say this is not the way to go. The sort of general feeling of it was, yes, this is a film about gangsters, but it's not the gangsters that we would normally expect to see in a Martin Scorsese film. They're not the flashy ones.
People always want to think about it in terms of Goodfellas, or they want to think about it in terms of Casino. And I mean, Goodfellas was about menace, and Casino was about excess, and that's what brought these guys, those guys down, those particular gangsters. But this one really is. They were much quieter men. They did not want to be photographed. They wanted, you know, they were well-dressed, but it wasn't flash. Jimmy is very, very well-documented over the years, and there were lots of quirks, you know, that were, you could pick up in the photographs about how he dressed and the kind of suits he wore, and there's a little bit of, you know, text about certain things that he liked.
I mean, there are other characters where there's less information, so you might get some sort of grainy newspaper clipping photograph, and then
right.
You'd have to sort of, from that, invent really what the rest of their wardrobe was. So one of the obvious things was the white socks.
Right, exactly.
I mean, he wears like smart suits, but then he always has these thick white socks on.
Yeah, and
which we did. And when I see it in the film, I look at it and it kind of jars for me. I go, oh God, he's wearing those white socks. But it's exactly like the photos. I mean, fortunately, the youngest that Robert De Niro is in the 50s. And really the kind of clothes we were putting him in as a young man weren't ridiculously different from the kind of clothes that an older man in that period would have worn anyway. So it wasn't like he was suddenly in jeans and t-shirt and a leather, you know, and a sort of, he wasn't like a sort of 50s teenager look. It was still a 50s man.
It's not only just like the size of our crew, but there were all these really, really specific scenes, all of which required kind of their own block of clothing that was then put onto the 6,000 plus background that we dressed head to toe. So that was, it's like we've been talking about, it's like we're making five different movies in a way, because we travel all these periods.
And then sometimes we'd do two in one day. Sometimes you do like two completely different periods. on the same day, and that was probably the hardest thing to do, is get your head round. You'd suddenly be going, hang on, where are we? Which decade are we in? You don't know what's going to be next, and I actually like that uncertainty. A lot of people think, God, how could you live with that, not knowing what's coming next? But I find that exciting. And, you know, whatever comes next is going to be completely different from what the last job was.
It's a great job because basically, you know, you get to work with people. You know, you get to have a new experience every, maybe sometimes it's once a year, maybe sometimes it's a couple of years, yeah, depending on how many films you do. But you're always learning. You're always learning something new.